गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस आवर न्यू टॉपिक ऑफ इंग्लिश ग्रामर, दैट इज प्रीपोजिशंस। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट प्रीपोजिशन एंड समथिंग अबाउट नाउन्स और प्रोनाउंस, बिकॉज प्रीपोजिशन इज बेस्ड ऑन नाउन एंड प्रोनाउन। So you have also a knowledge about noun or pronoun. So let's start our new topic, prepositions. Prepositions. Children, look at the following sentence. There are some examples for you by which you can easily understood what is preposition. So let's start. Number one, the jug is on the table. Look at the picture. There is a jug which is placed on the table. So the word on shows the relation between the jug and the table. Next, the duck is in the pond. Children, look at the picture. There is a duck which is inside the pond. So the word in shows the relation between the duck and the pond. Next, Sudha jumped into the river. There is a girl who jumped into the river. The word into shows the relation between the act of jumping and the river. Next, the house is behind the tree. The word behind shows the relation between the house and the tree. So here the words on, in, into and behind are placed before nouns or pronouns, and they show the relation between these nouns or pronouns and some other word in the sentence. These words are called prepositions. Means a preposition is a word which shows the relation between a noun or a pronoun and some other word in a sentence. Children, before understood preposition, you should know about noun or a pronoun. Although in your previous class you have already read about what is noun or what is pronoun, still here I'll give you some information about noun or a pronoun so that you can easily understood about the preposition. So we will start with the noun. Noun. What is noun? A noun is the name of a person, animal, place or thing. Here are some examples for you. Look here. Number one, the boy is jumping. The word boy is the name of a person. Next, the dog is barking. The word dog is the name of an animal. Next, that is a temple. The word temple is the name of a place. Next, he has a bat. The word bat is the name of a thing. So here, boy, dog, temple and bat are naming words. Naming words are called nouns. I repeat, naming words are called nouns. So, a noun is the name of a person, animal, place or thing. Pronouns. What is pronouns? A pronoun is a word used in place of a noun. I repeat, a pronoun is a word used in place of a noun. Some common pronouns are I, me, we, us, you, he, him, she, her, it, they, them. Here are some examples by which you can understand easily. Let us compare these two groups of sentences. Ritu is a nice girl. Ritu is my cousin. And next sentence, Ritu is a nice girl. She is my cousin. So children, I hope you understood about nouns or pronouns. So here we will start again preposition with the definition. So a preposition is a word which shows the relation between a noun or a pronoun and some other word in a sentence. It is on, under, and near that show the relation between the jug and the table. On, under, and near, that is the preposition. So here are some example by which you can understood easily and clearly about prepositions. So look, prepositions include some of the smallest words in the language, but we have to be very careful in using them. Our choice of the preposition depends on the relation we want to express. So here is an example. Look here. The jug is on the table. So in this picture, there is a jug which is placed on the table. So the jug is on the table. Here, on is the preposition. Next, the jug is under the table. Look at the picture. There is a jug which is placed under the table. So here we will use under. The jug is under the table. So under is a preposition. Next, the jug is near the table. So in this picture, the jug is near the table. Not on, not under. Here we will use near. The jug is near the table. So near is also a preposition. So preposition is used according to the, you can say that preposition used, it depends on the relation. So it is on, under, and near that show the relation between the jug and the table. So children, in this video we have already discussed about preposition and nouns and pronouns. I hope you understood about prepositions, nouns, and pronouns. In our next video, we will discuss about how many types of preposition and where we can use preposition. So, in next video, we will discuss about types of preposition. Thank you for watching this video.